Rocky and Bullwinkle and friends.
Today we will prove once and for all that there can be no life on the moon.
Dr. Milton Nudnik, Egghead of the Year, was given the honor of the first peek.
What do you see?
I see two moon creatures.
Impossible!
The scientists rushed to the eyepiece, and incredibly, Nudnik was right.
Why, it's a moon moose!
And he's signaling us!
What does he say?
He says, here we come, ready or not.
Sure enough, a strange rocket ship had left the moon and was heading straight for the Earth. The word spread in a flash.
X-ray, moon men to invade Earth! President declares emergency!
And some people did panic. Stores closed, houses were shut up tight. Everywhere, panic reigned.
What's the headlines, George?
Invasion from moon.
So what else is new?
Meanwhile, the fact that Bullwinkle's rocket fuel was made from his grandmother's fudge cake recipe was having a great effect on the whole country. Top scientists discarded their most complex apparatus.
Erwin, go get me an 8-inch cake tin and a set of cookie cutters.
Colleges changed their course of study.
This year, gentlemen, we will study atomic structure, nuclear physics, and fudge making.
In the USA, grandmothers rose to national prominence as scientists.
I'd like you to meet our new head of research and development.
Hello, boy.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair that I may climb the golden stair.
Now I'll climb down your hair, and when I get to the bottom, I'll explain my plan.
What's your plan?
Jump!
Jump? That's your plan?
Yes!
Some plan.
The name, sir, is Peabody, and I intend to adopt this boy. Naturally, the newspapers made a big thing of it.
X-ray! X-ray! Dog to adopt!